Many of us grew up being afraid of bats, thinking that they would wind up in our hair and give us rabies. And so those myths have really been an impediment to bat conservation. But really, bats are so important, and they're really quite cute. Defenders takes great pride that our building is now, since 2014, powered exclusively by wind energy. And we made this move because climate change poses the largest threat to wildlife. Responsible wind energy means different things depending on the landscape that you are in. The way Defenders looks at it is through a wind-wildlife coexistence lens. How can we develop wind responsibly so that both the development and wildlife can thrive? Wind energy is important because this country has vast wind resources, meaning that it can play a significant role in our transformation away from fossil fuels. We also know that wind energy can be developed responsibly, and we can have healthy wildlife habitats while still having significant wind energy development across the country. An increasing priority of Defenders' work has been interacting with bats and wind turbines. We are seeing increasing numbers of bat fatalities with turbines, and we see this mostly in the fall migration. It's just a two-week period where bats are coming through. The bats that are most impacted by wind turbines are migratory, meaning they fly through at the end of summer. And so these bats seem to be attracted to turbines. We don't know why. Some people hypothesize that these bats think those are trees and they're looking for a place to roost. Others think that there may be high insect populations around the turbines and they're foraging for food. Nobody knows why these bats are attracted. And we estimate that there are about 500,000 bat fatalities at wind turbines in the United States every year. The three species of bats we see most affected at wind turbines are hoary bats, eastern red, and silver-haired. And again, these make up approximately 80% of all fatalities. So getting in front of this problem before we even face a listing is a critical priority for us because it will be better for these bats and better for the industry. So I'd have to say my favorite bat right now is the hoary bat because we're spending so much time trying to protect it given the number of fatalities we see at wind turbines. You may think the name hoary bat and not think much of it, but if you see a hoary bat, they have these beautiful manes that resemble hoarfrost. And so some folks are trying to rebrand the hoary bat to call them sky lions. Deterrents are incredibly important for bat fatalities since bats are being attracted to the turbines. So siting turbines away from bats doesn't seem like a plausible solution. So what we need to do is deter them or keep them away. And so we're able to do that through ultrasonic deterrence, which is the sound at the frequency that their echolocation is at. So it doesn't significantly take away bat habitat or reduce where the bats can be in space and time. It just keeps them away from the spinning blades. The interesting part about the wind energy and wildlife connection is the future of wildlife depends on wind energy to address climate change. And the future of wind industry depends on its ability to site development responsibly for wildlife so it can reduce conflicts and gain public support. The most important thing that people can do to help is not to pit wind energy and wildlife against each other. We see so much in the media, they love to exploit this green versus green, but there isn't a conflict necessarily. We can achieve both. We can have wildlife and we can have wind energy, and we can do it responsibly. And there are a lot of people working very hard to achieve this solution.